people and how they have embodied the movement that we began here last year, January the 2nd. We started off with a lot of advertisements talking about this movement that was coming, and we've had the opportunity to experience the move of God throughout this place. This place will never be the same because God himself has showed up and has showed out and has used your young people mightily. So tonight, I want to set the tone that this will not be for form or fashion, but I challenge you to celebrate your young people, celebrate the accomplishments, celebrate them being open and willing to allow God to use them. Amen. 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 While we do that, I hope that I won't fall. but I am going to ask each person here just to kind of scoot up just a little closer if you can. And we're going to go ahead and get started with our program. Before we do that, I'm going to invite Gabriel Cerise to the front to open us up with prayer. We're going to invite God in this place. Before we do anything more, we're going to invite the Spirit of God in this place. Gabriel Cerise.
Can we all stand for prayer, please? It would be nice if everybody would touch somebody, whether it be a hand, shoulder, something. Your heads are bowed and your eyes are closed. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for waking us up on another beautiful Sabbath morning. I thank you for granting us traveling mercies on us on our way here to your house, Lord. I ask that you find favor in us finding your word, Lord. I thank you for granting us through another year. I ask that you watch over us as we are about to enter another year and that you flood it with blessings. In Jesus' name I do pray. Amen. You may be seated. Next we have the welcome by Ashley Taylor and Jada.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. I said, happy Sabbath, everyone. How are you feeling? That's good.
Welcome one
and all,
ladies
and gentlemen,
boys
and girls,
to the NB16 Awards Ceremony. Ashley, tell them what we got in store for them.
We have lots of fun and excitement and live performances that will knock you off of your feet.
So be prepared, because this award ceremony is going to be one for the books.
Next, I'd invite Mr. Michael John Hanna Jr. to give us our scripture and our motto. Put your hands together, y'all.
Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me.
Amen, amen. We have done some amazing things throughout this year. God has truly, truly, truly been in the building, and we're excited about this evening. We're excited about tonight, and I just want to take this opportunity just to kind of share with you. Spare with me one moment, I apologize. I just want to take this opportunity just to share with you some of the good things that God has been doing. So tonight, you have in store to hear from one of our own who has truly embodied this movement and has been able to start their own, not label, but their own project. And they are now a gospel recording artist. So you'll be hearing from none other than Miss Angel Monique. Give her a hand. You're also going to be hearing from two young men who I am excited that they are going to be our host and MC for tonight's program. One, Mr. Javon Taylor. Put your hands together, y'all. And Mr. Gabriel Cerise. These two young men have shown themselves and are not afraid to set the tone of any program. We've watched them throughout the year mature in their willingness to allow God to use them. So throughout tonight, you're going to hear from none other than Mr. Gabriel Cerise and Javon Taylor. Put your hands together, y'all, as our host and MC come before you.
We're singing?
We're singing? Hello, everyone. Can you hear me?
We're singing? I don't know what you're singing.
How's everyone doing?
Good.
All right, all right.
You want to do the, is it your mine or yours? You good?
All right, Javon asks if you could play something, please. Javon was going to have a quick little solo. He put...
No, I wasn't.
No, we just wanted everybody to get up and greet each other with a nice closing Sabbath hug.
Well, come on, give each other a hug.
We're going to play something.
You guys are so spread out.
Each other.
Can we have some people come closer, please?
Yeah.
If you're in the back, come closer.
Everybody get up, hug each other, maybe move a little closer, please.
Come on. Get up out of your seats, let's go. I don't know the song, but so I'm gonna start first.
I thought you were gonna do this. Still gonna do the joke? You have the cards, huh?
Yeah. Seems like everyone went back to their same seats. Please come forward a little bit, please, if you're all the way in the back. And I don't want to start calling out any names, but. All right, thank you for allowing me and Gabe to come here and host this award for you guys tonight. Proud to do it. Thank you, Mike. Well, when I was approached at first, I was scared and I was like, man, they asked me to do this? Like, I'm nervous. Like, the shyest person that you could ever meet, they're asking me. So when I was approached.
Said the shyest. Said the shyest person.
When I was approached, I was like, all right, let me sleep on it before I give you my decision. So went home that night, and to my surprise, I had a dream. And I don't remember the dream, but just know I'm here today and I'm hosting, so. All right. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get this started. All right, for this award, most influential. This person, like the whole MB16, throughout the year, just real smart. Can you guys hear me? All right, my bad. Real smart, when you see him always has a Bible in his hand. He's always drawing. Like, you go up to him, you talk to him, you can tell he has his head on his shoulders. And, like, whenever you talk to him, he gives you some kind of words of wisdom. And real smart man, that's all I can say. Category is most influential.
Yes.
All right. And that goes to none other than.
Wait, nobody has a drum roll?
Wait. No drum roll? Like. Drum roll. No? All right. No drum roll? No? All right. And it goes to. I can't read this. Whoever wrote this. No, I wrote it myself, my bad. Andre Henry. Andre, please come down. No, Andre?
I'll take it, thank you.
No, Andre? All right, so.
Well, we're gonna save this award for Andre whenever we see him. We have a nice fancy trophy for Andre.
Most influential. Most influential.
One more time, please.
Most influential. Amen. All right.
And in our category, in our committee, we have a lot of activities that people can participate in. And it's a lot. It's a very rigorous amount of activities. Mike can testify. Mike can testify. Yes, okay. And with this category is called most likely to participate in going out in the community and coming up in front of the church, doing anything. This girl, she's very willing to sing.
Yes, she is.
She know?
No.
Oh. I thought she did. She's very willing to sing. She always has a smile on her face. She's very well outspoken. And the category is most likely to participate.
Drum roll.
Can we have Miss Jaden Robinson to come up?
What?
I get it. Morning.
You want to sing?
No. Okay.
I would like to say thank you to everyone that voted for me.
Okay.
All right. You can wait for my mom to take a picture.
Wow. Thank you. One more time for Jaden, please.
One more time. The next award we have is called I Can Do All Things. There are more than one person in this category that's going to be getting this award. And these people have developed a trust relationship with God that rendered them limitless. They did things through God this year that they never thought they would do, and they understand through Christ nothing is impossible.
Amen.
Amen. This award goes to Alexia Hanna. And
That's one person.
She's not here to accept this award, so I'll be accepting it on her behalf. Kyra Murdoch.
Okay.
Dijon, if I say your last name wrong, I'm sorry. Matura. Okay. Right here.
You gotta take a picture. Huh?
Gotta get it. No. Oh, my bad. Give me this.
That was three over there?
Yes, those Christ ones.
Finish it.
Joshua Peterkin. Who's also not here. Francis Joseph. I know I seen
Frances
her.
Frances is here.
I know I seen her. Frances, Joseph. Oh, she's outside?
Okay.
She's outside? We'll wait.
Wait, she's coming. Oh, look. You have to make a walk down the entrance.
Okay. Me and God all day. All right. Yes. And we have a Rohanna Moise. Rohanna. I know I seen her here today too.
She's not here.
She knows.
The cookie, man.
All right.
I put it on top of this. All right. You can take a picture. It's my favorite.
Let's give them another round of applause for I Can Do All Things.
All right, this next category is called Push. Push is, at first it's a weird name if you really think about it, but you have to break it up. It's called Pray Until Something Happens, which stands for Push. And most of the youth are in a group called Pathfinders that all of you should know. And I think it was our last camp out. Something happened and James got mad at all of us. James said, everybody get down and drop 50. 50 push-ups.
I had the video if you guys want to see it.
Not 25, but it was straight 50 push-ups. And everybody's mad. I didn't even do anything. Why I gotta do push-ups? This guy, he's like, you know what? Let's just finish it. All right, so we knock out the 50 push-ups. I look in his tent after, everybody's mad, everybody complaining about their arms are sore. I see him praying. I said, wait, what are you praying about? I said, it's already done. We already got in trouble. He said, no, I feel bad. I'm praying that James will forgive us. I said,
aww. Yeah.
So this person, this award is going to be received by Mr. Chiron Murdoch.
All right, Chiron. You want to say something? You want to like pray?
No? Pray? No? You should pray. No? That's you.
Yeah. Dang, I don't know what to say about them.
Are you going to do it?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. This next category is called Most Determined. Next category is called Most Determined. These two girls, they do everything together. If one wants to go to the bathroom, the other one wants to drink water, they play in rock, paper, scissors, shoot. They make sacrifices for each other. And if you give them a task to do, and a time limit, it gets done before time runs out. These girls really do deserve this award. Most of you all know them. Maya Dixon and Mariah Dixon.
Maya and Mariah.
You got this one?
Yeah.
What's the next one?
Most multiple. There's three of them.
They good. Get them.
Congrats. You guys want to
see? You guys want to
take a picture?
You want to see the note?
You're gonna take a picture.
Oh, all of us?
Take a note.
Yeah. Hold. Prop this. Prop it up. One more time for Maya Mariah, please.
Next category we have is most willing to volunteer. These set of people, they're always lending a helping hand and always willing to volunteer. You always see them around church, whether it's across the street helping out, feeding the homeless, or in here helping set up. They're always there and you can always count on them. And it's no other than, drum roll please. Okay. Marcus Leverett, give him a round of applause, guys. You always see him, he's always has something to say. Marcus, you can always count on him. He's always at the school. Wait, stay right here.
Yes.
He's always at the school helping feed the homeless. And he's, every time you call him, whether it's snow, it's funny, right? Snow, rain, he'll be here, you know? Next person is, wait, no, come on, man. He's trying to run off the stage too fast. Rushmi St. Fort. She's quiet, but she's in the background. And those pretty balloons you see on the side, you can thank her as well.
Aww.
And last but not least, Miss J.L. St. Fort. The sister to Miss Rushmi St. Fort. Wait, 1 second. Again, quiet, but in the background. And definitely a helpful person. There you go. Huh? Yeah. And now we're gonna
turn it back over to Mike.
Thank you.
All right. God is good. It's awesome to see the good things that our young people are doing, where they're volunteering, they're most determined, they're most influential, they're doing amazing things. Why? Because they've allowed God to use them. We want to take this time to invite our secretary of our youth department, our youth ministries department, Mrs. Trizel Leaf, to the front. And we have a video which she is going to actually share with us, a year in review.
Throughout this year, I have learned to be intentional and deliberate in everything I do. No matter what the challenge may bring, for I know I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. The Nothing In Between movement, to me, is not just a quote or a basic trend, but it is a lifestyle where I am committed to let nothing stand between me moving to the next level, no matter what the challenges may face. I am determined to let nothing stand between. Throughout this year, we focused on tearing down the walls and removing all the boundaries that would prevent us from moving to the next level with God, our community, and church family. In the beginning of the year, we detoxify ourselves spiritually, mentally, and physically because we are preparing for the battlefield. We embraced our community 11 out of 12 months, and sometimes more than once every month, we visit the community. Sometimes to bring gifts or just to say, hi, how are you? During the celebration of International Prayer, we challenge our young people to stop, drop, and pray, and declare victory over all the battles and challenges that were ahead of us because we knew and still know who is in control. We even laid witness to this power where we were able to witness rainy days become full of sunshine with just a prayer. Our youth are on fire like never before. We celebrated 4 children and youth days where we focused on being intentional with our worship, praise, and our God. Our children were able to be preachers, teachers, directors, praise and worship leaders, for we firmly believe in training up a child in the way he should go, and when he's old, he will not depart from it. Kids and Individuals Desires for Salvation, commonly known as Kids Inc., made history by hosting the first D.O.Z. glow-in-the-dark party and service. For wherever there is darkness, we must glow. AYM and Kids Inc. worked together and hosted the March for Hope, the Love Project. We teamed up with City of Delray Beach and multiple law agencies. Our aim was to build community relations, awareness to our community, and police interactions, which even received media attention that was broadcast worldwide. This year was a success. Thank you, parents. Thank you, NB16 members. Thank you all. NB16, nothing between.
I believe.
Javon just wanted to tell you guys earlier that you guys look very nice. And if you guys don't, if you guys turn around, you see the camera, and he would like for you guys to pose for the camera and take on three. There's no camera. You can face back this way. All right, go ahead, Javon.
And I never said you guys look nice, so. But you guys do. All right, for this next award, man, this person is a one-of-a-kind individual, you know? When I say one-of-a-kind, she's real inspirational. Very talented, voice of an angel, I would say. Catch my pun? Did not let fear of the unknown keep her from reaching for the stars and becoming a gospel recording artist. The award she's gonna get is gonna be one of many that I know she'll get. Very talented, as I said. And please give it up for no other than, I need best drum roll you can get. Let me hear it, let me hear it. Angel Monique Davis. Angel, before we give you this, I've never had an award before, and you're going to be getting some later. Like, can I keep this? No? But this award presented to you for Reaching for the Stars, and hope you, I don't know what to say after that, but.
Thank you.
Here you go. You want this? We have coming up to sing right now is actually your one and only Angel. So, if we can please.
I believe.
Lord. Speak to me.
Speak,
Lord.
It's very hard to follow up after that, but Javon is very adamant about joining your group. He was over there singing next to me if you didn't hear him. Our next category, back to the awards, is most improved. This person, in the beginning of the year, Mike had a large meeting over in the room with it. We came together and we picked the board of who was gonna be doing what and who was gonna be on the committee. This person didn't wanna do anything, but they were willing to be on the committee. As the year went by, Mike kept pushing this person activities to do and feeding them the spotlight. And as the year went by, this person grew into the spotlight. They became the spotlight. Now we can't get this person out of the spotlight. And when I think of NB16, I think of this person. Can we get Mrs. Jada Raglan?
What? She ain't quiet and shy no more. She said she's gonna say something.
Thank you.
That's fine.
We're going back now after this? She said one?
Hmm?
I think you said one.
No, this one.
Before we continue, we're going to pause without giving out these awards because the sun's about to set, so we want to close out the new year and bring in our new theme. And for that, we're going to have Elder Jason Tracy. Amen. Amen. Yes? No?
Oh, he's coming. He's coming.
He's coming. Just give him a time. Remember, he's getting there in age. He ain't young like he used to be. Has baby and everything. It's that baby age.
Baby.
Wait, I forgot. Two babies. I'm sorry. Two. So, look at him. Any day now.
He was picking his hair this morning. Who should I get first? I didn't even get a chance to hear the jokes, so I couldn't even get back right.
The hearing's going too.
Yeah. Okay, so it was about an age thing. At least I don't look at Javon.
Ooh.
I didn't hear anything. I didn't hear anything.
You guys
else.
Didn't get it. He said he doesn't look it. That means he's not saying I look old. He's just saying he still looks young. So that ooh wasn't needed.
God is gracious. Truly a blessing to be here this evening, particularly when we're looking at these phenomenal gifts that God has given us through music, through community involvement, through fellowship, through love. And it's truly a blessing on this last Sabbath as the sun is taking its rest for the evening. We are in the house of God. And so just very, very glad and just humbled by that. As you all know, we've watched the news and we've seen people just one after the other, laid to rest. And we look at it and we oftentimes consider that, well, that's Hollywood or those are stars. But you look at literally a mother hearing that her daughter has just passed, and then she's laid to rest the next day. But we are here on the edge, literally on the edge, and the question becomes why? Why are we still here? And so I won't keep you long. I'm just going to speak very quickly from Exodus chapter 12 and verse 2. It says something there. I just want to read in your hearing. It says, "This month shall be unto you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year to you." I just want to just one more time. Can I just dig in there one more time? It says, "This month shall be unto you the beginning of months. It shall be the first month of the year to you." And so this evening, the charge, the word is simply own it. Own it. Let's pray. Father in heaven, thank you for your mercy and for your love. We ask now, dear Lord, that you will speak to us. Dear Lord, the last time that I will stand here for the year. The last time that we will sit here, dear Lord, for the year. And so we're asking, dear God, that you will speak to us and give us power to make the transition over. Dear Lord, do what only you can do. Move us, convict us, direct us, save us, I pray. In Jesus' name we ask these things. Amen. Very interesting. As you look at that particular verse, it starts out in verse 1. We're talking about own it. In verse 1, it says, "The Lord spake unto Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt." Can I just take a moment there real quick? Watch this now. God is simply saying this, and I won't take long. He's saying to them that today, the moment you're standing in, is going to be the first month of the beginning of months. And what it means is that this month, the moment you're standing in, is the beginning of your new year. But what he's saying is, I'm telling you that in the middle of Egypt. So you haven't made it out of Egypt. In other words, you haven't come out of the land of bondage yet. But I'm telling you, I am proclaiming, God says, by his manservant, that you are going to be delivered. Your freedom is coming. Your moment where you will be free from the stuff that the devil is trying to lay on you is on its way. As a matter of fact, it's not on its way. It is here. God says, this is your beginning. This is the newness of life. And so in that brief little verse, what I see happening is The children of Israel are oppressed. They've been discriminated against. They've been beaten. They've been downtrodden. They have financial issues. Their families are in disarray. But most importantly, their worship has been altered or impacted by this spiritual idolatry that's going on in Egypt. And God says, don't worry about that. I've already sent a message for you guys to come and visit me and spend some time with me. But I want you to understand, before you leave, I need you to walk in faith and know that this is the beginning of a new year. God was not looking at the calendar to determine whether it was December 31st, 2000 whatever, or 19 whatever, or 600 whatever, or you know. What God was simply doing was saying, because I am time. He was simply saying that because I stand out and I make time, I'm going to allocate and make some time in your life. And I'm telling you today, God says, I am telling you that I am marking out this time as your time. And I'm saying to us this evening, nothing has changed. God is telling us that this is the beginning of the first month of the first year. But that seems odd. What do you mean, the first year? You see, a lot of times, well, I won't talk about you. There's some stuff that's happened over the years I'd rather just forget about. See, I can't see you as much as I'm looking at you. I can't see a lick of any of you. It's dark. There's a spotlight on me, so I'll just talk about my life. There's some stuff that I'd rather forget about. There's some stuff that took place in 2016 that I just want to leave behind and never, ever revisit. God is saying, what I'm going to do for you, Jason, rather than just take 2016, I will take all of the years and gather them up and say, now this will be your beginning starting right now. But the only way it means anything is if I own it. I have to really and truly accept that this is my beginning, that God has said, here you are, and I can embrace it, and I have to be all in when I do it. Very quickly, and I just want to talk about the backdrop. We have a child by the name of Moses. Remember what's going on. The people of Israel, they have been, if you will, trapped in Egypt. It was almost by mistake. I said almost, but God had a plan. The Bible says Joseph went down. He was enslaved down there, and actually he made his way up to second in charge. He sent back for his family when his brothers discovered he was alive. He sent back for his family. The Bible says they came over, about 70 of them. And as they came there, Pharaoh had great favor. Joseph had great favor in Pharaoh's eyes. And he gave them land that they can live in. And they were all there, 70 of them. And they grew, and they grew, and they grew. You know how it goes. They get on die, they just multiply. And so they grew and they grew. And the Bible says that there another Pharaoh rose up who knew not Joseph. Oh, you'll see where we're going in a moment. I'll just say it now because sometimes I forget to go back, Sheila. A new administration came to power that did not know Joseph. There was a new administration taking over Pharaoh's palace, or the Pharaoh's palace. And they did not, that new administration had no idea of the beginnings or the struggle, if you will, of the people who are living there. And so what they said was, we are afraid of these people. So let's kill them. You know, can I talk? Can I just have a quick, this is not where the scripture said, hold up. Bible says that Moses was one of those who was born in that time. And as they were growing, they were killing the male children. But the Egyptians went back and told them, they said, look, Pharaoh, we've tried to do what you said. We're trying to kill these young men. But every time we go in, the women are so strong. That when the midwives go in, those who study midwifery, as they come in, they go before, but the child is already out and lively. They don't need us. The children are coming out strong and robust, and Pharaoh says it's time to kill them all. Kill the male children. And Moses' mother, when she has him, she sees a child. The Bible says she saw that he was a goodly child. Not just good to look upon, but his disposition had a different disposition. He was covered. It seemed as though the Spirit of God had already fallen afresh on him. She could tell he was set aside for a certain purpose. There are some of us here who need to believe that we've been set aside for a certain purpose in God's eyes, to glorify him. And if we would walk like that and talk like that, they wouldn't be able to treat us like that. Or, yes. By
Bible says they took Moses and they put him in a basket and they put him in an ark and they sailed him down the river. His sister Miriam's looking on. She's watching to see what shall become of my baby brother. You know the story. Man, I wish I had some time this evening, but I don't. I'm going to move on. I'm not getting an award for this. I need to hurry up. Pharaoh's daughter. The one who said, kill them dead. Y'all ain't catch that. The one who said, kill them dead. That means he really wanted them gone. Because you only kill or you're dead. When you want to kill someone, that kill him dead. That's when you're really just trying to get it done. The one who said his daughter shows up in the river to take a bath, sees the ark, and says, ooh, pretty. She looks at him, and he begins to cry and sob. And she said, this is one of the Hebrew children. Don't ask me how I know. And she says, it's one of the Hebrew children. She goes back to her daddy, the one who wants him dead, and tells the enemy to his face, daddy, daddy, please, can I keep him? Can I keep him? Can I keep him? Can I keep him? Please, please, can I keep him? Those of you who have daughters know what was going on. Pharaoh said, sure, have him. What's one? You picked the wrong one, Pharaoh. The Bible says he took God's child and raised him in hell's house. Gave him all of hell's assets, all of hell's resources, but brought his mother in. You don't see what God does. They brought his mother to raise him. So his mother is there teaching him who he is, teaching him whose he is, teaching him who he belongs to, teaching him the promises of God. And the Bible says when he got older, he recognized rather than live for a season in the pleasures of sin, I would rather suffer the afflictions of God's children. I'm talking about all in. The Bible says this same Moses, same. The same Egyptian name that he was given when she found him.
Yes.
Can we talk about that for a quick second? We don't get where his mother named him. You don't get that in scripture. You don't find where Moses' mother gave him the name such and such. All we get is wicked Pharaoh, his daughter, giving Moses an Egyptian name. That same name that you hear about on the Mount of Transfiguration. Sometimes they put a label on you. Sometimes they call you stuff. Sometimes they'll say that this is what you shall be known as. And God says, yes, that's fine. Call him drawn out of the water. I will cause him to walk through water. I will cause him to move water. I will cause him to allow water to run out of a rock by my glorious name. God allowed an Egyptian label, an Egyptian trained Pharaoh. Watch this now. Moses was trained to literally be an Egyptian Pharaoh. To turn around and become a mighty deliverer. And then he spoke through him and said, I want you to let them know that this day is the first day of the first month, the beginning of months, of the first year of their lives. But they have to own it. They have to be all in. Daughter of Zion, as we wrap up 2016, we have said there's nothing between. There's been some things that have caused some separation. There has been some stuff that's tried to get in the way of our relationship with Jesus Christ. There's been some things on the job that have messed us up. There's been not having a job that has messed us up. Our home lives are in disarray. God has said, make nothing come between us. The church has caused, it feels, to just have a separation. It feels as though there's something between us and God. And it's been a rough 2016, but God says, no, if you cause nothing to come between us and let me know that you're all in. Let that radicalism about Jesus Christ become the new norm. Let it be that you're so fixated on Jesus that you're going to cause whatever may have happened to go by the wayside, because today is the beginning of the first day of the first month of the rest of your first year. Why is that so important? Remember your first year when you just started that new dream job? Remember how that felt? You see, the first year on a job is better than the 20th year on a job. Because on the first year of the job, you'll actually take some, you'll take some good training and you'll listen to good guidance and counsel. But by 20 years in, nobody can tell you a thing. First year in that relationship that you began in that first year, that relationship was different than it was in the 20th year. Remember that first year of marriage?
Uh-oh. Somebody got uncomfortable just that fast.
Remember that first day, that first year of college, young people? Remember that first year of college, you went there, you bought a book bag. Remember that? Had notebooks and pens, you didn't know what you needed. What am I saying? New tablet. How about that? But that first year is that joy, that exude. One last example. Can I just remember that first year when you became a Christian? Remember how that felt? No one could tell you a thing. You were on fire for the Lord. You would come to church with not only a Bible, you have a matching hymn, though. Remember that? Amen. Some of you came in with every testimony to the church. Came with a whole stack of study work that you needed, and you would come to Bible class, and you would be there for Sabbath school, and you would study, and you would have questions, and you would ask your questions. That first year in your Christian experience, you would come to prayer meeting. You would be there for the all-night prayer meeting, and you would travel near and far because there was an evangelistic service going on somewhere, somehow, and you would told your family, every non-Adventist or non-Christian you could find, you would call them and tell them about this good news. It was your first year in. Because as on fire as you were, surely they heard they would be on fire as well. The first year, it felt like the best year. You know why that first year was so great? They didn't let you sit on any committees. You were too new. You weren't called to be an officer in the church. You were too new. You were a babe in Christ. They treated you nice and gentle. You know, the first year, they were gentle with you. Hi, happy set. Are you all right? Happy set. You want to go? Are you hungry? Do you need some? And they would take you home.
Yes.
Some of these aging members, you know, you haven't been invited anywhere in the last 15 years. That first year, God says, when you met me, when you first fell in love with me, he says, let this be the first year. The beginning of your first year, but you have to own it. Don't let anyone take your joy. Don't let anyone try to snatch it from you. You got to be all in. You got to go hard this year than ever before. There's a new Pharaoh in the land. He doesn't know you. He has no idea, and he doesn't care who you are. I speak not of who you think I speak of. Your adversary, the devil. He's seeking to destroy you. He has revamped ways this year, young people. There are some new drugs out there that have come out this year. There's going to be a new blend of cough syrup and some other weird, just experimental stuff this year, young people. There's going to be some new gender rules this year. But you need to own that this is the beginning of your first year with Jesus. And when you own that thing, God says, yes, you'll be in the presence of your enemies, but I will prepare a table before you in their presence. I will use their resources to glorify myself in you. And that which he did for Moses thousands of years ago, He wants to do the same thing with us and with you. He wants to glorify himself in you. But you have to be willing to let him do that thing and own who you are. I'm done with this last thing here. Watch this. Moses could have easily made it seem as though he was an Egyptian. He knew the language. He had been taught. He had their clothes. He had everything that he could have looked. He could have fit right in. But he chose to say, that's not who I am. Me? I am a child of God's. I'm owning who I really am. And so this evening, the charge is simply to own who you are and who you belong to. Don't let the world try to define you and tell you who you are and strip you of your identity. I'm going to close with prayer. And the prayer is this. And let me say this first. Don't get uncomfortable if you are not ready for this prayer in your life. And what I mean when I say don't get uncomfortable, I want you to be uncomfortable. But I don't want you to be uncomfortable to the point where it makes you stand up. Because you have to own this prayer in this moment. Because there's some stuff on the other side of this year that's getting ready to take place. If it's your desire to say, Lord, I want to own whatever comes my way in 2017 through Christ Jesus. I believe I can do everything that needs to be done to show who I belong to in 2017 through Christ Jesus. So whatever they bring, I'll stand on the promises of God and I'll own it. I will own who I am and who I belong to. I will not succumb to foolishness, but I know I can't do it on my own strength. But by your grace, O Jesus, I will be an overcomer and I will own the fact that I'm a child of the King. If it's your desire to own the fact that you're a child of the King, it talks about lifestyle. It talks about all types of entertainment, things that we get into, stuff that simply draws us away. I'm not suggesting that you should try to be perfect on your own. What I'm simply saying is, are you willing to yield to God that he can have ownership over your life and you can own what he has in store for you? If that's your desire, I'm going to ask you to stand for prayer. Watch this now. It gets uncomfortable because that means some things are going to come. And when those things come, you have to be able to say, not by my might and not by my strength, but through Christ Jesus, I can do it all. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for your mercy and for your love. We thank you for 2016. Dear Lord, the road was rough. Dear Lord, we've had some trying times throughout this year, but thank God it's behind us. And so now, oh Father, we stand here and your young children, dear Lord, they're standing before your presence. And they're saying they're willing to own, dear Lord, that they are kings and not servants, dear Lord. They are willing to own, dear Father. They have royal blood running through their veins by the virtue of the sufferings of Christ Jesus. And dear God, they are standing here, dear Lord, and they're saying, dear Jesus, we own the fact that you own our future. It is not dictated by a professor. It will not be controlled by some female or some male. It will not be controlled by some other force. It is Christ Jesus who has our future, and we own that thing. And so, dear God, we are praying right now for strength everlasting. We're praying, dear God, that you will rain down upon your children power from on high. Dear Lord, we need you. And your children, dear Lord, they need you every hour. So I'm praying, dear God, the same way you kept Moses on a river leading, dear Lord, who knows where. Right into the enemy's hands. And you kept him, dear Lord. And you protected him, dear Father. And you raised a man who said, I will not let anyone own me. I belong to God. Dear Lord, I'm praying over these lives right now. That you will let them know, dear Lord, that you have paid the price. And they are free, dear God, from the bondage bondage of Egyptian, dear Lord. That Egyptian symbolism, dear Father. They are free from idolatry. They are free, dear Lord, from that lifestyle. They are free, dear Father, from any type of emotional and sociological slavery, dear Father. They are free. They belong to you. Allow them, dear Lord, to walk in the strength of your might. Allow us, dear Lord, this year to walk differently than we walked in years times past. May we walk stronger. May we, dear Father, walk with purpose. May we speak, dear Lord, words of power, of life. And when you shall return, dear Lord, if it be this year, may we all be gathered up to meet you in peace. Dear Lord, we own what you're giving to us, our inheritance, by virtue, by the blood of Christ Jesus. Deliver, dear Lord, as only you can. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you.
I wonder if you need a good father in your life. What Elder Tracy was just saying was how the Lord took Moses and what he did for him. How his mother was able to be there for him and teach him the things of the Father. And that's what God wants to do for us. I'm glad that in spite of everything, in spite of who I am, that's just who God is. He's been good to me. Has he been good to anybody else that's not deserved? He's been good to me. And the song is simple. I want you to sing it. And it simply says,
you're a good
that Yeah.
all I can say is, wow, God is good. We serve an awesome God, and we are excited. Thank you, Angel, for your ministry in music and what you are allowing God to continue to do through you as you continue to minister here, out of state, and God's willing, across the world. This opportunity for us to kind of acknowledge these young people who have embraced this movement, the people who have stood apart, people who have embodied this movement of God and has allowed God to continue to move through them. I'm going to ask, and we've closed out the Sabbath, and we've entered into our new year. We've ushered in our new theme for 2017. We're going to go all in, where radical is going to be the new normal, where we are going to move forward in a way like we've never done before, passionate in our pursuit for Christ. Amen. And what we're going to ask for you to do, we're going to take a quick pause before I invite our host and MC to come back up front. I am going to ask for those who want to go all in and to help your youth department to continue to do things, We went to our year of review, and you saw all the great things that God has been able to do through your young people, and you want an opportunity to be able to support. You want an opportunity to be able to say, hey, you know what? I want to set aside, I want to sacrifice for our young people. They have been doing such an amazing job, and I want to be able to sacrifice. I'm going to invite our ushers to move to the back and to collect that sacrificial offering that you would like to donate to your young people. Amen? It gets quiet when you start talking about money. It gets crickets. But your young people have been doing an amazing job, and I am proud of them. Your young people have been recognized across the world, where news has come here to see some of the things that your young people have been able to do. And I think that you should be able to give sacrificially. Give until it hurts. And the reason why is because we're in a new year. We don't know what this change of administration, change of Pharaoh who knows not Joseph, on what that may be like. But we know that we're going all in for God. Amen. 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 So as they are collecting, give you a few moments. We need to turn on the lights so y'all can write some checks. Go ahead, get the lights on. Just so that you can see that extra zero that you want to put on there. Amen. You want to make sure that it's legible so that when the bank gets it, they know exactly what you meant. We can get the lights real quick. Thank you so much, so much. So we're excited. Again, are they collecting? Ushers, please go ahead and begin to collect. And as we do that, we have nine more. How many more? Nine more, and we're going to conclude with our Mr. and Mrs. B16. And so this is definitely something that you don't want to leave. You want to stay. You want to hear. You want to see. And immediately following the conclusion of our program, we're going to go over into the gym, and we're going to have our glow-in-the-dark New Year's Eve party, where we're going to have a safe environment for our young people to bring in a new year. Is that all right? Is that all right? Where we have food. Free food. Amen. We have games. We have fun. We have a lot in store for you this evening. And we're just going to bring in the new year with God. And we also have a fireworks display that you certainly don't want to miss. And the glow-in-the-dark party will begin promptly. Afterwards. anyone been overlooked before we pray? And also, immediately following this, the conclusion of this program, we're going to have Angel Monique's CDs that are going to be for sale. Get your CD. If you have not, it's a perfect gift for that. You know, we always wait for after Christmas sometimes to get those Christmas gifts for those family members or friends that you may not have seen in this season. So get your Angel Monique CD. She will be signing and autographed your very own copy. So get one for your friends, your family, your neighbors, and share the gift of love, the gift of this music in me. By Miss Angel Monique. And I think that she has a new project that she's also working on as well. So 2017, you will be able to see her new project that will be coming out in the next couple of moments. We've been collected. Has anyone been overlooked? Any checks still being written? They're still writing. Amen. And we're going to pray. Father God, we thank you. We ask that you would take what has been collected, that you will bless it, and that you will multiply it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Lights.
Nobody's going to get the lights?
Thank you. All right, as we continue these awards, the award we have coming up, person we have coming up for this award is Most Helpful. They're always helping around, whether it be in the kitchen, although they're not actually helping cooking, but they help some way. With ushering, with the kids, they're always lending a helping hand. You can always call on them and they'll be there to help out. Very good person at heart, and this award goes to Benicia Augustine.
We're gonna kind of relapse because I saw somebody in the crowd that wasn't here earlier to come pick up their award. This first one, it was the first one, is Most Influential. And as we repeat, it is Andre Henry. I saw him in the back. Andre. Please give it up for Andre.
You got the award for Most Influential.
It's the pose. Look at the pose. There it go.
And we have another one for Ariel Hannah Moise.
I gave it to her.
Oh, you gave it to her?
Yeah.
All right, never mind. She already got it.
All right. This next category is called Most Present, meaning they're always here, always volunteering, always helping. This person always has a smile on their face when it comes to any activity. I remember here, I forgot what, it was, we were going up to the Heat game down in Miami, and we were counting up the tickets that we had to get and like for the seats on the bus. And James looked at me, he said, "Did I skip anybody?" I said, "James, you forgot this person." "Well, I don't know." I said, "James, no. She's here every time. You gotta put her on the list." he said, "Are you sure?" I said, I put everything I have on it. This person is always here with a smile on their face, no matter what it is. This person is always here. This award goes to Miss Jerly Joseph.
It's your award.
Yeah. You gotta take a picture. No, it's free.
This next award is most dedicated. This person is dedicated to the church like no other. Like when you say her name, you think of flashing lights, think of cameras, plays, skits, like she's all about the drama. You know? And whether she knows it or not, everything she does, she's always bringing people together with everything she does, and she's a very warm-hearted person, and everything she does, she puts her all into it, and I know we all appreciate her. And very talented as well. Please give it up for Maranatha McBeam. She said she has a speech.
Thank you everyone for your support in giving me this award. I don't deserve it, but I don't. But
tell us why you don't deserve it.
But thank you anyway for your support and encouragement.
This next award goes to MVP, Most Valuable Player. That's in the church, not in the court, because this person's funny, always smiling, very dependable, very respectful. When you see him, you already know you're going to have a good time. And he's a real good friend to everybody. Like, when you see him, you can't miss him. He's tall. I can't say he's handsome, but he's all right. Please give it up for your MC, your host, Gabriel Cerise.
I didn't even know I was gonna get this, to be honest with you. I would just like to first and foremost thank God and my mom. Thank you for this award. All right. This next award is basically most well-rounded, to be honest with you. They get every category. This person can't have a title on their name. That's how amazing and blessed and happy they are. This person you could always depend on if you need a ride somewhere, if you need food, if you need a hug, if you need a smile. This person you can always count on. I would like everybody to stand for this last award, please.
And not the last, but...
Well,
yeah.
For one of the most best.
One of them.
If that makes sense. I would like everybody...
And the funny thing is, story time. First time I ever met this person, met them, I can't remember when, but we was in Key West. And I met this person because I took a picture of them sleeping in church. Shame on them, right? But let's continue.
All right, I would like everybody to put their hands together for Miss Carrie Ann Dixon. Wait. Show the award that you got.
Gotcha.
And then put this one, this hand. This one over here.
Wait, you're blocking it. And the picture of her sleeping, if you look up there, no, I'm kidding. And for the next couple of words, we're going to turn it over to Mr. Mike Hanna. Thank you.
All right. I would like to invite Ms. Latoya Hanna to the front to help me.
Latoya Hanna.
All right, so we are going to do the Mr. and...
and Mrs. Oh, Miss.
Can we wait to go to the stove?
All right, so this person who are Mr. NB16, so this person, known this individual throughout his entire life, watched this... So watch this young man grow and watched him mature. And what you originally would have thought as a very shy, bashful, if you will, quiet spoken, has evolved throughout this year, truly embodying this nothing between movement, where they have stood up here and boldly declared that they will not let anything come between them and God. So much so that I got a text, and this text came in about three weeks now ago. And this individual texted me and he said, "Mike, can you please text me the pastor's phone number? I want to commit my life solely unto God. I want to give him and surrender my all to him." This is what the movement is about. I want to invite none other than Mr. Jordan MacArthur as our Mr. NB16.
Well, I just want to thank God for allowing me to get through this year and allowing me to grow as I did. I want to thank my mom. Can't see. It's very bright up here. And all your futures are shining in my eyes. It's really bright. Sorry. But I just want to thank my mom and everybody who supported me throughout the year. I want to thank Michael and Ms. Latoya for always like pushing me to do better. And thank you.
Amen.
And now for our Mrs. NB16. This person, always jovial. Whenever you need her, she's always there. Always in the kitchen. She claims she can cook, but I've never seen her cook. She's been to my house and she says she can cook, but she still haven't cooked. But she has a spark and she's just always willing in everything, and she claimed it, she prayed it, and she is. So I would like to welcome Ashley. This is NB16.
Yeah.
Hello, everyone. First off, I can cook. But I just want to thank God and my wonderful parents. They are relationship goals, yes. And I just want to thank Javon. And for everyone for always supporting me. I love you guys.
All right, so our Mr. NB16 Junior, this individual, This individual also throughout the year, seen him truly embody the movement, really kind of seen the maturity as the year has gone by. This young man had a rough beginning in the sense of listening and being obedient and wanting to participate. I remember knew him as a little child, and I remember his first opportunity when he had to go up front, how bashful and how scared he was, and how he had a scripture to recite, knew the scripture, but wouldn't say it. And there was a time throughout this year where we saw this individual up front leading out the entire choir during Children's Day. And I have to say, for this recipient, I am truly, truly proud to present Mr. Junior NB16 to Michael John Hannah Jr.
Get that hand right there.
Now for our junior Mrs. NB16. This person, she's young, but she brings herself like quite the lady. And she's always active. Whatever program is going on, she's always here to support. Her mom always bring her. And always, hi, Mrs. LaToya, how you doing? And she said, how's the kids? And she's always like engaged with all the young kids. And we just want to give it up for Mrs. Mandy Bertie.
And I forgot a word. I don't know who wrote this. I don't know. Trizzo, you wrote this?
I think so.
This handwriting is bad. But.
Oh, this award. Yeah, I wrote this. Can I have all the NB16 members join me?
I could read this quite well.
He's not going to read anything, though.
So throughout 2016, Michael Hanna has been our leader, which has allowed God to lead him. And he has been a very influential leader to the youth group as a whole. We have, his name is the fearless leader. So on three, I need you guys to say, thank you, fearless leader. One, two, three. Thank you, fearless leader. Can I have Maya Dixon to join me, please?
Throughout this year, I have gathered that AYM isn't a department, but a ministry. It has played the role of pilot in my life. AYM has not only directed, steered, and guided my conscience, but caused me to realize why we love, witness, and pray. I've learned that church isn't just confined to the walls it is built of, but that we are accountable for the souls of our community, and that no man should be left behind.
Yes. Yes.
The NB16 movement has embodied courage, strength, and faith. It was intended to be confined to a year. However, the intentional impact it has made should be expanded to an eternity in attempt to continue to allow doors to be opened for the youth of this church.
Mike, I would tell some stories, but I don't want to embarrass you. This child. Okay, this award is for Mike, and we had the NB16 logo engraved for you. And it says, Michael Hanna, AYM leader, for your outstanding leadership and dedication to the youth of Daughter of Zion, Seventh-day Adventist Church, and the community.
And also, babe, you've been such a great... You've been such a great support to us. Whenever we come to you with any ideas that we have, you know, it may be ideas not so good, but you never discourage us. You always encourage us, figure out a way how we can work it. I'm home with you, so I know how the late nights you're up and, oh babe, what can we do? What can we do? So you are truly fearless for the Lord, you know, for your youth, for the church, and we just want to say thank you. So we made this plaque for you, and it's upside down, sorry. And we all signed it. We just want to say we love you and hope you continue to go further the work of the Lord. So thank you.
Not normally lost for words, ever. but I can truly say thank you. Wow, like I don't really like, you know, stuff, but thank you guys. And I'm just excited for you guys, because I can truly say that this year would not have been the year that it was had it not been for your individual sacrifices. those late nights that you guys put up with me on those phones, those conference calls, and those the challenges that I always put before you guys. And you've met and exceeded every single one of them. And so this is not about me, but about what God has been doing through you. And that's why we can say nothing between. Nothing between us, the bonds that have been forged here in this church, in this, wow, I'm speechless. But God is good. God is good. Thank you, guys. And I pray that throughout this next year, as we challenge ourselves, now that we have torn down those walls, those things that stood in between us and God, us and our community, us going further with our relationship with God, as we move into 2017, we're going to go all in. And that all in means like we're not holding anything back. Amen. We're not reserving any for later. We're going all in.
Yes.
Where radical is going to be that new normal, where we are going to be passionate in our pursuit for God unlike we have ever done before. So we ask for your prayers, we solicit your prayers, and we invite our pastor, Pastor Paul, to come up and just close us out with remarks and prayer for our ceremony.
You know, it's going to be probably a scene that's not a whole lot different when we get to heaven.
Yes.
All the saints are resurrected and we get there and meet Jesus face to face for the first time. And there's going to be a whole line of us. John says it's going to be a number that no man could number. And as we come by, for each and every one of us that makes it, Jesus is going to be handing out some crowns. It's going to be the award ceremony of, I can't even say the decade of the century. Nothing will ever be like this. And we're told that the crowns are going to have stars in them. But then as we read, and we read particularly in the writings of Ellen White, she says that as awesome as it's going to be for us to be there at that award ceremony, as expensive, as lavish, as whatever, as these crowns are that he gives us at this award ceremony. Ellen White says that she saw the scene and she saw the saints reach and take the crowns and they cast them at his feet.
Yes.
We talk about what it cost for us to get there, the stuff that we will have gone through. The times that you went out to try to witness to people and they slammed doors in your face and they cussed you out and all of that kind of stuff. And the things that have gone on in our homes and in our families and in our churches and just the stuff, you know, the messy stuff. But in that moment, somebody will ask you, was it worth it? All of the times when it was your friends, not it was your best friends that stabbed you in the back, was it worth it? And that our response would simply be that heaven was cheap enough. We won't even be able to remember the stuff that it cost us to get there. All we will be able to remember is what it cost him to get us there. I long to be a part of that award ceremony. And what you have embarked on here, this youth ministry team, this group, you have embarked on a journey that's not over, it's just beginning. Because there are still men and women, boys and girls, families in Delray who need to see Jesus in 2017 through you. And so while this year was about nothing between, as we go forward into the new year, there still needs to be nothing between you and your Savior, nothing between me and my Savior. But as we continue to do ministry, what we cannot promise you is that it will not necessarily be easier next year than it was this year. As a matter of fact, chances are it'll be harder, it'll be more difficult, there's going to be more challenges, there's going to be more obstacles, there's going to be more criticisms, there's going to be more naysayers next year than this year. But if you have firmed up your foundation this year with that nothing between, you will not just meet those challenges in 2017, you will excel. And it is our prayer that as you do what God has placed in front of you, that what you do, and I'm talking to our young people, that what you do will serve as an example to the rest of us as you continue to let God be your closest and dearest and nearest friend. Let's stand as we close this evening. Heavenly Father, we have seen and heard marvelous things in this year, in this day, and in this night. We've heard stories and seen how you have led patriarchs and prophets in the past, mighty men and women of God in times past. But Father, we've seen how you've done some awesome things right now. But Father, as we position ourselves to embrace a future where there's lots of questions, we don't know everything that's going to be coming our way. Father, we ask that you would make it our purpose not so much to be concerned about embracing the future as we are about embracing you. Every morning when we rise, every night when we go to bed, every moment throughout the day, keep our eyes focused, stayed, trained on Jesus and his matchless love, his wonderful mercy, his power to save. Help us not to get discouraged by the things that we see and that we hear around us. But Father, keep us consecrated, dedicated, committed to the mission to which you have called each of us, from the youngest even to the oldest. And then, Lord, when all is said and done, and we are gathered around the great white throne, and we see Jesus face to face, Father, make it our purpose, make it our desire to be present and accounted for at that eternal award ceremony. And we will give you all the honor and all the praise and all the glory. We ask this in Jesus' name. Let everybody say amen and amen. Amen.
All right. We thank you all for standing by and coming out to support. And we have a gift for each and every person that has come here tonight. Last year, we passed these out, and I was talking to the team earlier. We did this on Youth Day, and we passed out these bands, and we declared nothing between in 2016, and so much so that we embraced that movement, that we wanted to put a reminder on our wrist so that while we're going through the work week, going through the problems on the job, going through problems in school, we know that we won't let anything come between us in 2016. And it was amazing to see how many people still have those bracelets and still have those things, those reminders. So we want to give you a new set. And this one says, all in, with God, all things are possible. When you go all in and you allow God to be the captain of your ship, all things are possible. So we have a gift for you. Thank you for supporting us throughout the year. And as we enter into 2016, we know that all things are possible as long as we have God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So if you would like a reminder or a bracelet, please come up front. This gift is for you as a part of our youth ministry. God bless you. We ask that you give us until about 7:30 just to finish setting up in the gymnasium, or those who would like to come over and help. We all family, right? Amen. So if you'd like to help set up for our glow-in-the-dark New Year's Eve party, we have a lot of food. We have a lot of fun in store. So if you want a safe environment to bring in the new year with family, friends, and putting God first, we ask that you come across the street by 7:30 or earlier if you want to help us out and support your young people. God bless you and have a happy Sabbath. Thank you.